motion is equally phenomenal. That one I'm about to read is the backstory on how it came to pass that this was made available to Kay within days of Dwight's passing. And I think it was the day we got together after she got back from Atlanta and asked Kay if she had any pictures of Dwight and his youth and so forth. And she was disappointed to report that no, he had lost his picture somewhere along the way. And I think it was Wednesday of that week, so you know, this is three or four days later, that she received a package in the mail that came from one of Dwight's good friends down in Atlanta, who had been moving, in the process of moving, found this box that Dwight had left behind whenever he was living with him for a short period. And in this box was the record of his early years and the mementos of his growing up years, baby pictures, school pictures, you know, how that goes, the report cards and family photos and so forth, and also a couple of albums. And in the one sketchbook in the middle of this, Kay went through, she found this note that Dwight had written to himself, and it was the thoughts that he was struggling with at that time, and he just, for whatever reason, put them down on paper, not knowing how meaningful it would be to her. 16 and a half years later, he wrote these thoughts in 1998, and being very introspective of himself and who he was as a person, really getting in touch with himself at that time. And this was just a year or so before Dwight and Kay met in Juniata County, and he put the big boom on. So, wants to tell that story, you probably have to hear that person again. And I'm not going to let that out of the bag. It's a very interesting story, I'll say that. And, I don't know if this guy has something to do with him hanging out there talking. Anyway, excuse me a second. Just want to start before I read this, what moving tributes this has been to Dwight, not just how he has affected us with his artistry, but also his love for his family. It's been very special for me to hear those comments from all of you. Everywhere he went, that's right, his pride and joy, number one pride and joy, was his wife and his children. This was written on January 5th, 1998. And it's in his handwriting, so it's sometimes just a little difficult. It's not quite that of a doctor, but it's pretty close. So if I struggle with it, just give me a chance and I'll be able to interpret it. But he says, here I am at 36, thinking to myself, I thought I would have known where my life was going, and I find I haven't a clue. I find myself deeper in the world of art than I've ever been. You would think that this would bring peace of mind, but it makes choices much harder. It's strange to say, but the more I have found my talent and so-called calling in life, the more confused I have become. As I know not the direction to go in. My heart wants to leave this dirty city. I thought the same thing about it, man. And find my soul in the mountains of Montana, painting wildlife and taking long walks in nature, surrounded by the things I love so much. But I must stay here for now and work to save money so I can leave when I want. It becomes so hard at times because jobs can be tough to find. If I could find more steady work, I could find a way out. I ask God every night to help me see what I should be doing with my talent. And each day I get little pieces to the answer. However, I still feel the hardships of the daily grind of being a hard-headed artist. I feel I should get a full-time job because it's almost worth it. I feel I should get a full-time job. However, it's almost worth money in order to paint whenever I please. I know that's not right and it's selfish. Another issue is my heart. Except for my heart and soul grow hard. I seek the kind touch of a sweet woman to soothe my fears of life alone, to hold me and to love my vision of the world around us. I do have faith God will answer all of these questions in time. I suppose I am too impatient. More and more I find myself with the sounds of beautiful music and ideas for wonderful paintings in my head. I feel like if I walked up to a canvas, they would all just pour out for days and days, and suddenly a huge weight would be lifted from me. I feel the disappointment of some of my friends lately, as if I should do more with my life. Perhaps that's the reason he was being introspective and writing these thoughts out, because the pressure we sometimes put on one another before writing. And if anything, what was the wrong performance? You know, he marched to the beat of his own drum. That's one of the things I heard more earlier. The good side and the bad sides to that, right there. You know, also a worldly life is sometimes difficult when you're living with the artistic mind. But he was feeling that pressure, and he was writing these thoughts down. He said, I feel as if I should do more with my life, that I have no plan, no vision, no urgent goals for me. Perhaps my vision and goals are unrealistic, but they are mine and therefore built in me and very important, but quite possibly misunderstood. But they do lack direction a lot of the time, and it's something I have a hard time with. So he was kind of processing that as he wrote these thoughts out about the direction that his life was going to take. And as you heard testified so wonderfully here today, this is the Dwight that we got to know a few years later and love and appreciate these qualities about him. And you know, how he would get a concept and it would just pour out, so there was no need to tweak it or to, you know, to make changes. It's powerful. He said, I guess God made me an artist for a reason and not a business-minded, goal-oriented person. This is very frustrating a lot of the time for me as well as others. However, I do very well when it comes to the completion of my artwork. And then in parentheses, he writes, good thing. And we can say amen to that. So this writing, perhaps, is the law, or maybe a release, probably both. I feel somewhat better. The confusion of words and phrases has calmed. I need to write more to record the days, to give thanks for all I do have, not so much for what I don't. For my friends and family, for Shug, that was his dog, and my artwork, my peace of mind, and my artwork and God gave me, for giving gifts to me. Thank you. I just hope my lessons in life will be learned with more ease than in the past, that I can move through my changes with grace and pride, that I have the strength and heart to improve my life as well as others through my dreams. Isn't that incredible? It's so powerful. I just love that so much. And you know, he didn't get to settle in the mountains of Montana, but he did come to the mountains of Pennsylvania, and we are the beneficiaries of that. We found that sweet woman who would understand most of the boundaries of artistic drive and mindset. And I do know this, that she was very supportive of Dwight as he followed his dream. And additionally, he was blessed with two terrific children who, interestingly, share that artistic DNA. And by the way, you may not be aware of this, but in my humble opinion, Kay is an incredible artist in her own right. And as you have an opportunity just a few minutes to the gallery, if you don't know, behind that wall, it's small. It's set up exactly as Dwight had completed just a few weeks ago. And in the two corners,